do adults learn best with so much on everyone's mind between children and you know, this and everything else? It's tough to really sit down. And it's not like you're in college when the only thing you have to do is study. You have other things to do, right, including work.
So one of the things that people can think about is, again, when we go back to this notion of broadening our view of what learning actually is, if I ask most people, you know, how do you like to learn? When you need to learn something new, typically what do you do? And if I were to ask you that, what would you say?
I would say reading.
Okay, so that's a big answer. A lot of people read a lot of books, and if you think of some of our most well-respected leaders in business, whether it be Bill Gates or Mark Zuckerberg or Elon Musk, all these big CEOs, what do they talk about? Crazy smart people, right? And what do they talk about? That Mark Zuckerberg gives a reading list of the books that he's reading, and every 2 weeks gives a new one. So he's reading a book every 2 weeks, and I think Elon Musk is known at one point of reading 2 books a day. So, you know, I mean, imagine these crazy smart people, and those are some of the ways that they're learning on their own. But do we often say, oh, I'm building new skills, or I'm learning because I'm reading books? People don't necessarily equate that. The other thing is that since time is, you know, crazy, and there's so much content that's being thrown at people all the time, I think people learn when they have time in different ways. So for example, I love listening to HBR IdeaCast. It's one of my favorite podcasts, and I love to learn from that. And when I'm hiking on the weekends or when I'm commuting to work, I'm putting on podcasts that I like and learning that way. And that's one, or I'm reading a lot of articles as well online, or a lot of things like that. So YouTube, a lot of people say they Google or they watch YouTube videos for learning. And so now there's ways that you can fit chunks of learning into your life if you think about how you might be able to incorporate that. A lot of people are doing it anyway and they're just not realizing it. But then if you're more conscious about it, you can say, oh, I can actually put a goal in place and I want to listen to, you know, a podcast a week or read a book every month or whatever your goals are, and realize, hey, I'm actually making some progress in learning.